Okay, so we're talking about event pages. And so I'm going to show you guys my event page for the quarter force. And then we'll jump into Melissa and I's takeaways from the retreat. But really quick, let me share my screen on how, or on.
To how much girls talk.
So if you guys can all mute yourselves, that'd be awesome, because then we won't hear background noise. But okay, so I highly recommend pinning to the top a coaching call to action, but for this quarter force launch, I'm going to pin my event. So you can pin it to the top, which is, do you see how I, can you guys all see this right now?
Yeah.
So that's what I'm going to do right now, because it's, I want people to know about this. So I'm pinning it to the top. So now that's going to be the first thing you see when you come to my page. And then let me click on it so you can kind of see what's going on. So I shared it in several places. I shared it in my newsfeed. You can even share it in Messenger with different people. I shared it on my personal page and talked about it. I invited lots of friends. This is why it's important to have interest lists. Like I invited some of my crockpot friends. These are my interest lists. So I had a crockpot group. And all I did was select all. It was really easy. So anyway, I maxed out on my invites, which I highly recommend doing. This is why you want to do your own, because you want to invite as many people as possible. And don't be embarrassed. Like, this is not like putting someone in a Facebook group. This is inviting, like sending them an event, and they can either say interested or going or not, you know?
Can I ask a question?
What?
Can I ask a question?
Yeah, what's that?
About the pinned post at the top.
Yeah.
It doesn't show on the iPhone or on the phone version of it, and it just says view pinned post. Do you find that people miss it when they're on their phones?
Yeah, they might, but they're going to miss it whether it's pinned or not, you know, because it'll get buried by your other posts.
Oh, that's true. Okay, cool.
You know, so, okay, so... Let's see. So I just did a really short, I would make it short and sweet, intro about it. And that included a preview video, the preview video on YouTube. You can just search for it, of course. I made it last as long as possible. So I made it October 25th to November 7th, because our group, the Team Sheet group, and I think Melissa, yours is the same, is starting November 7th with prep week.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I made it, that was the longest I could do. You can only make them 2 weeks long. Anyway, so you can invite your friends, you can share it in your newsfeed, you can send a messenger, and then you can post in it. So I did a post today, you can't really see it, but with a video about my review of a quarter force workout. So like I said, every day I'm gonna post different things. I'm gonna post before and after workouts. I'm gonna post, before and after pictures. And all you have to do is Google quarter force transformation photos, and you can like find those easy.
So many. Yeah. And there's tons in the Team Inspiration file. I can't remember what she called it, but
yeah, she called it quarter force launch or something. Anyway, so I'm just going to keep posting in there constantly. And then, of course, I'm going to message these people that are interested, these three people and the 14 people that are going. So I also boosted it just because I really, like I said, I am milking this launch because I want to be the first person that they hear about quarter force from and the first person they buy it from. So I boosted it right here. It says add budget to reach more people. You can boost an event on your Facebook page. So... just some ideas for you guys on how to do it. It's really, really simple and user-friendly to create an event. You just go look right here. You just go here where it says offer event, and you click on it and fill it in.
Do it tonight if you haven't.
Yeah, for sure. Do it tonight. So any questions on that before I stop sharing? Okay. Also, Super Saturday is this Saturday. You guys try to go. It's like such a big deal. And for those of you that are in Utah, I'm speaking, so you have to go. You have to go because I'm so nervous and I just want to get it over with. But I want
American Fork Junior High, I believe, right?
I need to double check.
I looked it up. So if you're in Utah, which I know a lot of you aren't, but some of you are, it is in American Fork. So I just took a screenshot. It's American Fork Junior High from 8:30 to noon. So
Be there. Go to find yours locally. They're like, I love going. It's just so fun to see all these other coaches and like hear their stories, and I a lot of cool tips from them. Any other announcements that you have? I'm gonna mute everyone. Unmute yourself, Melissa. Okay. Any other announcements you have, Melissa?
No, mine was just for the, and I also wanted to talk about, and this is good because we're doing it together, the coach test group for Core to Force. So make sure that as soon as it's available on November 1st, you get your order in so you'll have access through Beachbody On Demand. And we'll start that Monday, right? Is that what we decided?
And we're doing it through the tracker app, right?
Yes. So I've started getting it set up already, and we can get people added as soon as possible. So if we want to maybe.
Yeah, we should just start there. So, like,
yeah,
I'll add myself and then I'll have to figure out how to add everyone else.
Me too. Okay. So just so you guys know that that's coming up. The reason why these test groups are so important, and this was one of the things that they talked a lot about at leadership, so it kind of like segues really nicely, but there are so many times where coaches are like, oh my gosh, like how do I get picked for a test group? Like, why am I not in the test group? People in the test group have such an advantage. And then Amy Silverman, who you guys probably know her, right? She's like number two in the company, number three. She was talking about how she, with launches, especially, she just acts like she's in the test group and she runs her own test group. And I think, you know, we've done that for a long time, but I don't think people really understand how serious the test group is and how important it is to actually take it and use it as a test group. You guys have an opportunity to follow the meal plan, to stick with your workouts, to go all out with this launch. And like Kelli has been saying, you know, milk it for as long as possible. There is not going to be a new program that's released at the beginning of the year, which is unusual for us. We usually have something new to talk about. So Core to Force is going to be the program that we are all and that all coaches are sharing about. So make sure you take advantage right now of this program, get amazing results. You know, take your nutrition very seriously. Don't just go, oh, I've used those containers before. Like I know what my portions are. Actually use the containers and share how the containers work and talk about them a lot and talk about your workouts and share videos. And, you know, as long as you're getting people really excited and talking about your results and sharing results of your challengers and other people, other coaches on your team and on our upline team, you're going to get a lot of people who are excited about it for a long time, even after the initial launch month. Okay. So that's what this coach test group is for. It's for you guys to have an advantage, you know, a week before anyone else gets their program, really, and share your experience with it. So.
Yeah. And I'm all about like, get that before, like do it for the after photo. Like my goal is I want like killer before and after pictures from this program because I freaking love it. And I want people to join me on it. And I just really want those before and after pictures. So like it's such good marketing when you do a full program, you do the nutrition as best as you can. I mean, obviously you're not going to do 100%. You could, it's very possible, but at least do like 90%, you know, do your best. And then I think you will be surprised at the results. I'm excited. I'm going to do it. Like I want to do it to the end of the year.
Yeah. I was going to say too, Kelli and I were able to get a program at this leadership event. And so I got to do, and I'm sure you did the same workout today, but it's so different than the preview that everyone has tried. Like, this workout was not cardio. It wasn't like you're running in place, bouncing back and forth. This was like a really, like, balance oriented, like, targeting specific muscles. It was tough. I thought it was really hard, but anyway, so lots of fun things that I think you guys will get out of this program. It's gonna be really good.
Okay, quick, one more announcement, and then we'll start our retreat takeaways. Our team is doing a sneak peek into coaching. It started today. It ends tomorrow night. So try to get 5 people in the group. I'm doing, anyone that gets 5 people in the group gets to enter to win an iTunes drawing, iTunes gift card drawing. So I'm really busting butt trying to get 5 people in there. I know it's hard, but that's the goal. Make that your goal every month. So take advantage of these sneak peek groups. They are crucial. All right, I think that's everything. So I think we're going to jump right in. And I think we'll just take turns. How does that sound, Melissa?
Yeah, that's great.
Okay, I have so many notes. I'm like, where do I start? Do you want to start?
Sure.
Okay.
Okay. So one thing, there seemed to be like a theme at leadership. And there were a lot, I already shared some of the videos with my team. But there were a lot of, I don't know what you call them, presentations. there were a lot of coaches who shared some really great things. But the one that I felt like kind of set the tone for the entire leadership event or weekend and really stuck with me the most was Allie Upham's, I don't know what you call it, talk. What do you call these things, Kelli? Her
speech,
presentation.
There you go, presentation.
Her presentation was so, so good. And honestly, for me, what I took away from her is that it's all about helping people. And I know you guys are probably like, man, we've heard that a million times, but it's all about helping people and really focusing on the people. Like, finding joy in who you're helping and what you're doing for the right reasons. She talked really straightforward. Like, if you guys watch it, you're going to probably be like, whoa, like, I didn't know people got that. Like, it wasn't heated, but like, she spoke with a lot of power. And she kind of talked from a place where she's been a coach for 8 years. Okay, she's like one of the first coaches in the company. And so she's been around the block a time or two, right? And she's seen coaches come and go, and she's seen a lot of new faces and a lot of different ways to run the business. But it seemed to me like we are here for one purpose, right? That's to help people live healthy and fulfilling lives. And if that doesn't bring you joy, you know, if helping someone and seeing someone succeed and seeing someone reach a goal and helping your coaches do the same and just really being in it for them and for that, I think you're not in it for the right reasons. And it's going to be a really hard job if you're only in it trying and thinking about the money or the rank or the volume or whatever it is. But what you focus on is kind of where your mind goes to. And I think just coming from a really good place and having integrity in your business, not just signing people up with a challenge pack and being like, good luck, see ya, hope it works out. Like, really following up with them, really caring about their results, really giving them the attention that they need and the help that they need. And I'm sure all of you do that, but this is just kind of what I took away from her. And she just spoke with so much passion that I felt like was something that I wanted to be as a coach, something I wanted to be better at as a coach. Because I know, and I will tell you, like, there are people who joined my challenge group in my first year of coaching that I did not give the time or the attention to that they deserved, right? And now that I've been in it for, you know, over 2 years, my business has changed a lot. And that is my focus. And actually, one of my coaches was talking about today in our little thread, how, you know, her best coaches are challengers. And that was another thing that came up at leadership is, you know, the people who have a belief and who have experienced a transformation and a change in their lives because of, you know, Beachbody, because of a program, those are the ones who are wanting to share it with everyone else.
Yeah, they talked a lot about, like, it just seemed like so much about, like, the focus needs to be on our clients and helping them get results. And when they do, I mean, I feel like my best coaches, when I really think about it, my best coaches have had results. You know what I mean? They believe strongly in the products. They've had that transformation. And so that's the goal. Like, that is the whole point of what we're doing, is to help people get results. So that kind of just really hit it home. Like, okay, it's so simple. Like, that's what we need to focus on. And one of my goals is, like, I want to have 52 transformations, like, every year, meaning one per week, one every Transformation Tuesday, or sometimes I post them on Wednesday. You know what I mean? If you're constantly posting at least one of your clients every week, then you're constantly, that kind of gives you, keeps that goal at the forefront of your mind of, like, okay, who's had a transformation? Like, trying to get those before and after pictures, encouraging them to take before pictures. Just things like that. Like, it's been a huge goal of mine to try to get more, because I feel like when I get those transformation pictures, then they can see too that they got results. You know what I mean? They can see that, because sometimes you don't see it until you take your before and after picture or take your measurements or whatever. So, like, that's been a big goal of mine. And so my goal is to try to get one every single week and try to post one every week. Because then not only are you, you know, bragging on your clients, then you're showing people that, hey, your clients get results. So then other people want to join you. But I was like, yeah, I really need to make the focus come back to my clients. Because sometimes they had a quote that said, I think I posted this in my team group, that said, your job isn't done after they buy a challenge pack. Like, you don't just be like, sweet, 2 points, peace out, you know. It's like, no, we got to help them get results. We got to check in with them at least once a week. And he and Carl Deichler said, or they posted a statistic that said something about phone calls. This kind of really hit me hard. I was like, okay, I need to at least call them, like, once on the phone. I'm trying to find the graphic. It said something like, clients who get a bi-weekly phone call, meaning, like, at least 2 phone calls during their 1 month that they're with you in a boot camp, it said they had, like, a way higher, it was like 18% higher chance of success or something. I'm trying to find the picture, but
it wasn't even, like, Beachbody related, I don't think.
No, it was just like a statistic.
Yeah.
You know, trying to find it, because I was like, oh. Oh, and also said customer converted coaches earn 14% more in their first year, because they're like, if they were a customer first and then a coach, they're going to earn more money because they probably believe in the products more, and they, you know, people saw their fitness journey. So people believe that it's going to work for them too. Here it is. Okay. It said, Stanford study findings. Participants who received a biweekly call asking about their fitness progress increased their amount of exercise by an average of 78%. And I was like, oh crap. Like, I got to start calling my, because I have a friend who's a health coach in another company, and they call their clients every week. And I was like, we don't. Like, I will message them on, I call it follow-up Friday. Well, I'll follow up with my clients once a week, and see how they're doing. But I was like, it'd be even better if I could just like call them, even if I have to leave a message and just be like, how are you doing? What's working? What's not? Let's pick one goal that you can work on for the next week. Anyway, that just really kind of made me want to at least call them at least once or twice during the group, which means you got their phone number. You know, or maybe at least text them or send a voice memo, like something a little more personal than just like a message or nothing. If you're not messaging them at all, then gotta up your game. So
I like how he called them. He said they're organic advocates. So they've gotten the results and they're already like, think about so many people that you see who are like stoked when they lose, you know, 5 or 10 pounds and they're sharing about it, they're not getting anything for it. Those are organic advocates. These are the same type of people, but if we're encouraging them and lifting, you know, uplifting them and helping them and supporting them, they're more likely to get those results and organically share with their friends and their family and everyone they know. So
yeah, so be thinking of some ways, you know, that you can, and we can, you know, brainstorm about these in our team groups, but just ways that you can improve, like, the client experience, you know, so that they do get better results. So that, like, one thing I'm working on is I'm trying to make a meal plan that is based around how I eat. Because, like, and I'm calling it the Busy Mom's Meal Plan. I'm trying to figure out just how to keep it really simple, like, simple snacks, simple dinners, like crock pot dinners and stuff like that. Because my sister-in-law just joined one of my challenge groups and she's like, here's the thing. Like, I do not have time to work out. I don't have time to even eat healthy. Like, she's like, you know, it's just easier to order a pizza or whatever. So I was like, okay, I want to make it so simple. I want to make it so simple that, you know, that my sister-in-law could just be like, oh, okay, I'll just make this super simple, meal or the super simple snack or whatever. I'm trying to simplify it in any way I can. Anyway, so if you guys think of anything, like let's brainstorm together, you know, in our message threads or our team pages and think of ways we can like improve their experience, because that's the whole point of what we do, right? Sorry, I kind of jumped in. Any other thoughts, Melissa?
On that or on leadership?
Both.
I have a lot. There were a few things like really action-oriented items that I wanted to share. In a lot of our trainings and even in the Diamond Dash group, if you're in that, we talk a lot about doing specific things and reaching out to people and attraction marketing and posting certain things. And so there was a presentation kind of about attracting new clients. I don't even remember who it was that did it, but there were some action steps that they gave us and I thought they were really good and I've already started implementing them and I wanted to share them with you guys. So the first thing they said was to write down 10 things that you love. So this could be anything like, I love Lululemon. I love reading. I love, you know, you just think of 10 things that you love, shopping, eating, whatever. And go then and join groups aligned to those things that you love, okay? Or search hashtags of the things that you love. And he said, the next thing that you need to do is create a video about what coaching has done for you. A lot of you have probably done that if you're in the Diamond Dash or if you've been in other Diamond Dashes or groups that we've done. So, you know, just talk about what coaching has done for you. And then from your like page, create a Facebook ad highlighting any free groups. So kind of like what Kelli and I teach a lot, you pin that video at the top of your like page. You run some ads for free groups, for groups that you're providing value for free. So people, you know, don't feel like they have to invest anything when they don't know you. I think, at least I know I'm that way. Like, I would rather buy something from someone I know than someone I don't know. So if you feel like you can build a relationship with someone and get to know them through a free group or through groups on Facebook or by talking to people on Instagram through hashtags, you're going to start building these relationships organically. You're going to start to develop friendships, or, you know, you're going to start to get to know people that you maybe otherwise wouldn't have gotten to know. I know that a lot of people are thinking, you know, sometimes in our group we give these what seem like really challenging tasks. I don't know, assignments for the day, like go and invite 20 new people or talk to 20 new people today. And a lot of my girls were like, well, I feel like I'm just talking to the same people over and over. So these are ways that you can go and find new people, reach a whole new market. If you feel like you keep running into the same people and over and over again, you need to search a different hashtag. You need to get into a different group. You just got to, you know, get out there and expose yourself to a whole new audience. And honestly, one of the other things that they talked a lot about was getting really transparent, really sharing. I mean, you don't have to go and like spill your deepest, darkest secrets to everyone, but, you know, share the honest truth about how you feel about certain things or like your workouts. Maybe, you know, nobody is perfect. I was actually talking with one of my brand new coaches today, and she's like, I don't even know what to share because right now I'm just lucky if I work out like 3 times a week. And I was like, yeah, but you have been working out 3 times a week and you've lost 10 pounds over the last month. Like, that's cool. You know, that's something a real mom could relate to. And she was like, oh yeah, like that's true. I guess that would be something I could share about. Like, I don't have to be perfect to see results. So just being honest and true. And if you're struggling with something, there's probably someone out there struggling too. And I know it's hard to get vulnerable. It's hard to share things that are close to your heart, but I promise you, you're going to feel a lot more supported. In your mind, you probably think, oh, people are going to judge me. People are going to think I'm crazy, but really you're going to have a lot of people coming out and supporting you, uplifting you. It might help you get through something that you're struggling with. So did you want to add to that? I saw you like lean forward. I didn't know if you had something to throw in there.
I remember I was going to, and then I forgot. I remember you said something about just the added, just, yeah, it was interesting because a lot of the top coaches were saying that they don't create ads for, I mean, I think Micah has done one about coaching and had a little bit of success. In fact, I asked her, I was like, so Micah, have you done like a Facebook ad about coaching and had any success? And she's like, yeah, but it's usually from people who already follow my page and are starting to get to know me. So that's why they were saying to, if you're going to do a Facebook ad, do one that is about one of your free groups. So that people are like, oh, they can like build a relationship and sort of learn to trust you first. And then, you know what I mean? Before just being like, join my team. Yeah, hey, I know you're joining my team, you know?
Yeah.
So it was interesting to hear that from a lot of the top coaches. I'm trying not to jump around too much.
I know. Like, one of the other takeaways. Oh, did someone have a question?
No, go ahead.
What was that, you? I couldn't tell. There was this quote that, like, I wrote down because I loved it. And I think it was Allie Upham who said it. But she said, and I'm going to say it slow because it's kind of, you kind of have to think about it. So it says, not theory, but the flight of the wild duck will lead the flock to fly and follow. So what that means, and I'll say it again in a minute, but when you think about a wild duck, they're flying in their own path, right? And sometimes that is what is going to attract other people to follow. And so she says, not theory, but the flight of the wild duck will lead the flock to fly and follow, and will not only help your challengers and the people to kind of take that leap of faith, it'll also help your own team, your own coaches, people who maybe are struggling to do something that they haven't done before. But it's just getting the courage to kind of blaze your own path, to blaze your own trail and do something that you haven't done before. I know as a coach, when I was very brand new, I really wanted to do everything that the top coaches were doing. I was kind of imitating their posts. I was kind of following their footsteps. And it wasn't until I started to blaze my own path and be myself and really post from my own heart and talk about the things that I was passionate about, that's when my team really started to grow and flourish and to do the same. So just one thing that I loved and I think is so good for older coaches and newer coaches to hear.
Yeah, it's funny because I tried posting like one of the top coaches. I was like, oh, okay, I'm going to do it how she does it. She's obviously killing it. And so I started like trying to do it that way. And it just didn't jive. Like it didn't work for me. It wasn't me. And so I was like, you know what? Screw it. Like I'm going back to doing my own thing. I'm not going to look sideways. I can't be her, you know? And so now I think it's good to follow like top coaches here and there, but don't follow them so much that you're like, oh crap, she just did something about this. I need to do something similar, or, but you know, where it's like, you want to be inspired, but not like imitate, because you got to be you. And that was one quote they said. They said, you don't have to be amazing. You just have to be you. I think you guys do that pretty darn well. Love seeing some of your posts that are so just like branded to you and what you love. Okay. I'm going to share a couple more random takeaways. Another one was just like I love this quote because it just shows the power of personal development. But she just said, your business will grow in proportion to how you grow. So this is why it's so important that, you know, because I see so many of you, like so much potential in so many of you guys. And I'm like, oh my gosh, she's going to be amazing. She's going to do all these awesome things. And then I hear some of you say, oh, I just don't have any confidence. And I'm like, what? Like, I'm surprised because I think you should be confident. I think you're amazing. You know what I mean? But if you don't have like that confidence or that belief or whatever it is, you know, if you're struggling with your personal development, then it's like you're going to cap. And so I do think personal development is huge. So anyway, that was a favorite quote. Okay, I'm just like wrote random quotes. One of the girls talked about joy setting instead of goal setting. She calls it joy setting. It was Alia. You kind of mentioned this, Alia Bum or whatever her name is. And I liked this idea. She just said like to find joy in the journey. Like think of the things that you enjoy in this business. Like what gets you excited in this business, you know, and do more of that, you know? And she just said, like, finding joy in the journey. If you're having fun, I used to always, like, I had a church leader that would always say, if you're not having fun, you're not doing it right. And I totally believe that. If you're not, and I think this applies to your job, it applies to being a parent, it applies to, you know, whatever. But if you're not having fun, then you got to find a way to have fun again. Like, make it fun for you. So whether that is like making pretty graphics or taking pretty pictures or, you know, doing like nerdy business stuff or whatever it is, or just like if you love like going out to lunch with people and talking to them one-on-one in person, like do more of that because those are your strengths. And like typically what you are good at or what you love is what you're probably good at.
And she said, with joy comes belief. You know, and she said, the lifers will be here with joy. The people that are like sticking around forever, it's because they love what they do. And if they don't love it, they'll find something they do love. You know what I mean? They said, like, there was a quote about a program. If you don't love the program, find another program. And I feel that way with everything. Like, if you don't love the way your challenge groups are run, find a different way to do it. If you don't love the tracker app, or if you don't love the Facebook groups, like, find a different way. Find something that brings you joy and base your goals around that. So instead of goal setting, it's joy setting. So I thought that was just a cool concept. Yeah. And then,
she said is leave an open door. So like if someone is participating in your challenge group or it's not the right time. Sometimes people are ambitious and they buy a challenge pack and they're ready to go and then life happens. You know, don't just be like, all right, cool, well, you know, see ya. Like you gotta leave an open door, like let them know when you're ready, I'm here for you. And follow up with them. Don't leave them hanging just because they were 2 points that you got and they weren't ready at the time. Like those are people that you're still committing to help. And I love that she just said, you know, follow up with people who have been your past challengers, see how they're doing. Because everyone needs constant support. It's not something you only need for 30 days and then you're done.
Yeah. And I love, that was I wrote one-on-one. Like, instead of talking to the whole group, the whole challenge group, or the whole, you know, maybe you have a forever fitness group. If you message people one-on-one, or if you better yet call them or see them face-to-face, like that is so much more powerful. That was just like a huge theme, was like one-on-one, like talk to your coaches one-on-one, talk to your clients one-on-one, try, let them hear your voice, like show them that you care. And so that was something that, you know, it's hard when you have like, when you've got kids and you're busy and whatever, but I think just like making time, that's the important stuff to do. Cause that was another thing. This one was really, they called it, are you a transformational coach or a transactional coach? Meaning, are you helping people get transformations, or are you just like, okay, did you buy, you know, like you bought the challenge pack? Great. Good luck, you know? And that one was like, oh, like made you think, like, am I a trans, you know, it made you really evaluate where you're at as a coach. But yeah, she said, get back to the joy of helping people, right? That's what it really is all about. In fact, that reminds me, I was telling Melissa about this fun competition I want to do in November. Yeah. Team to team. So we always post in Team Chic, we post how many people we've helped that month based on like the number of challenge packs sold. And I was like, wouldn't it be so fun if we did like, cause I know they're doing like the Team Spirit competition and stuff, but for some reason that feels almost like too like elusive and like general. And so I was like, but what if it was like Melissa's team versus my team? Like, bring it. Let's see how many people we can help. Like, I'm a competitive person and I like to help people. So it'd be cool to like combine those two and be like, all right, Team She's got to help more people than the team. Is it Team Fit Crew?
Yeah.
Okay. Anyway, I think that would be fun because then it's like a good competition. We're all working towards an amazing goal of helping as many people as possible. So are you guys down for that?
We thought that'd be fun. I haven't even talked to my team about it.
I know. I just remembered it right now. Don't look too excited, Jody. Anyway, I think that'll be a fun competition starting in November. So what else? I have more to say, but I don't want to talk the whole time.
Okay. I loved, so you guys maybe or maybe don't know Brigida Linford. Her presentation was so, so good. She, she's a coach who I think has, like, really, she rides the ebbs and flows of the business so well. And she gave five steps in developing loyal customers and productive coaches. So I wanted to just list those for you guys. Write them down, because these are honestly, like, they're money, and it's something that we need to be focusing on every single day in the people we're talking with. So number one, the first step was to listen to their stories and ask questions. I think that's so important. You really need to get to know the people you're working with so they know you care about them. You know what their needs are. You're really focused on helping them. So listen to their stories and ask questions. Rather than just, like, jumping into a conclusion or, oh, you need this or you need that, or she called you, we'll fix this. Really listen to what they're struggling with, and, you know, ask them, you know, how are you, or what can I do, or how can we, you know, just asking them really questions that are going to help them. Number two, make their agendas your priority. So you never want someone to fit into your agenda, right? You want to make sure that you're focused on their agenda. Some people are going to join a challenge group for accountability. Others are going to join because they're just hoping and praying that this is going to work. Everyone's going to be on a different level. And so you've got to meet your coaches where they are. You need to, or your challengers and your coaches, but you need to meet them where they're at. They're down here and you're up here. You can't expect them to climb to you. You kind of have to meet them where they're at and help them where they're at currently. And if you do that, I think that was something that I really liked to do as a teacher, especially because I remembered being in classrooms where it always felt like the teacher was talking down to you. And I hated that feeling. And so I always tried to, you know, get on the same level as my students and really understand where they were coming from. And I think it's the same thing with challengers and coaches. So number two, make their agendas your priority. Number three, and this one's so simple, but it's really powerful, I think. Believe in them. Believe that they can do it. Constantly uplift and support them. Believe that what they're doing is going to work, because sometimes they don't even believe in themselves. Number four, discuss ways to accomplish their vision and their dreams. So this one, I think, kind of goes along with number two, but it's like problem solving, thinking of what they need to do to accomplish what they're hoping to accomplish. That's something I ask all of my challengers is, where do you envision yourself over the next 2 to 3 months? What do you want this challenge group to do for you? And when you hear from them, well, I really want to lose 10 pounds, or I want to fit back into my pre-pregnancy genes, or, you know, you can talk with them about some reasonable goals and goal set with them and talk with them how they're going to accomplish that. So, like, for example, I had a mom who had 10 pounds to go. Okay, here. And she basically was telling, she's like, I'm struggling. I can't get these 10 pounds off. And so I told her, I said, okay, you know what? The last 10 are the hardest. So you got to buckle down. The nutrition is going to be the 90% of where your results come from. And when she did that, you know, the weight started to come off. So you have to really get honest, ask the hard questions, and be real with people. They're not going to accomplish hard goals unless they're really putting in the work. And if it's not a great fit, like with your coaches, if what they want to accomplish doesn't fit well with what coaching is, maybe it's not the right fit. And I liked how she said that's okay, because it's not always the right fit for everyone. Okay, and then this is the kicker. This is the best one. Help them until their vision is accomplished and beyond. You help them until they hit their goals. You don't ever leave them. You know, they're not just a point. They're not a number. Help them until their vision is accomplished and then even beyond that. And I just love that. I thought that was such a good, those tips I think were so good because it really takes it to the challenger. It takes it to the person that we're working with. And that's what's most important. So thanks, Jody. I loved that one from Brigida.
I think that's the one.
What? Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think that's the one you missed.
That's the one I napped through. My bad. Okay. Do any of you guys have a good system for like, okay, here's something I used to do, and I'm trying to come up with a good system because these are all great tips, but it's like, okay, how? Like, I want to know exactly how to do this. Like, I want a system because that's what I love. I love systems. So I used to do phone call Fridays and I'd have them talk to me on the phone and I would write down their goals, my client's goals on a Google Doc. And then when we talk the next week, I'd be like, hey, what are your goals? Let's review your goals. And then I'd have them on that Google Doc. So it was like, I had them written down. They saw them and I shared the Google Doc with them so they could see it. I'm thinking about doing it again. It was just kind of, sometimes it was hard to get my clients on the phone. I used to try to have them sign up through Acuity, but then they never would. I might need to just call them and do it. But it was cool to do like FaceTime or like even a Zoom call and then talk to them. I mean, type while we talked. So anyway, I'm curious if any of you guys have like a good system for how to execute this, like how to really find out their goals and then help them accomplish them.
I've kind of been passing this on to my coaches, but I've been using Ashley Smith's system and it's not like foolproof, but I give my coaches a packet at the beginning, or not my coaches, sorry, my challengers, a packet at the beginning of every challenge. And I ask them questions. So I ask them, like, how do you feel right now? They write down all their measurements, their weight. They write down three goals that they have for the challenge. And then every week they set new goals and they just write out how do you feel? Because sometimes, and I'm sure you guys have all experienced this, sometimes people don't lose weight right away. And they're like, why isn't the scale moving? This is depressing. This must not be working. But if they take their measurements every week and if they write about how they feel, you know, exercising and eating better and drinking Shakeology, then they start to realize there's so much more than just the scale. There's so much more than just what they look like and feel and the size that they are. And it really helps them kind of think about internally those changes that are happening. And that has worked really well for me lately. And I feel like I've got more people. Yeah.
Where do they write this? In the packet? Like, are you like, okay, show me a picture of your packet or like.
They send me a picture every week. Yeah. They also have their before pictures and their after pictures.
They all send you their before picture? Mm-hmm. And then in the pack, and then they send you a picture of what they wrote
each week. Mm-hmm.
Is this the packet that Ashley Smith did?
And that's I just changed it a little bit to be mine.
I just started that as well, so I don't know if it's going to work, but I just adapted. She must have adapted from Ashley Smith. And so I just took some of the stuff out because I felt like if they were doing their measurements and pictures after every single week, that could set some people back because they might not lose.
Sure.
Of, you know, especially if it's the last 10 pounds. So I just put measurements, you know, at the beginning and then halfway. But I assumed that I'd be discussing with them because I usually tell everybody anyway, like, I mean, that's part of what we in our prep week, right, Kelli? I think so. About not necessarily, oh yeah, screw the scale Saturday. I'm like, I know we say that somewhere. Yeah, so I usually like try to make sure that they do know that, because that's probably the biggest thing that people say to me is, oh, I haven't lost any weight, and blah, blah. So I took a little bit of that out, but yeah, it has the spots where they're saying what their goal is going to be and then what they want to accomplish each time, and then write down something they have accomplished. So I'm hoping that helps, but I also ask them their goals before we even get started so that I already have that in writing and can remind them that, hey, our very first conversation, this is what you said you wanted to accomplish.
Yeah. Do you write those anywhere?
I just keep them in our conversation and then I just scroll back. I just have like the name of all of my challengers that I have to keep checking in with, and then.
Okay, we want to see these packets. Okay.
What did you say?
Would either of you? So would you mind sharing your packets so we can see them? Can we share them in here? No,
I mean, like, I don't think so.
Yeah, I can send it.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah. We gotta, I like that system. Okay, I wanna talk about one
thing. Sorry. I was thinking of, okay, so some people the tracker is really working for and some people it's really not. Like, so when we did the health bet, I had a ton of people that were really active. Obviously, they were trying to make money, so maybe that made a difference. But then for this round, I have people not logging at all, obviously.
Yeah.
But I thought, would it be good to have people in our regular, like, Facebook challenge groups that we do, but also ask them to put their before photos and their measurements and have a spot that they can also log workouts and stuff, like for, you know, each of like just our challengers. Because I like that part of it. I like that it has that there and I can log in and I can see their before photos and I can see everything that they've said and like literally every measurement. So it's the same thing. Like it's also in the packet, but I didn't know if it was something that would be good to offer that, I don't know, that it's online somewhere. I hate that we're not using the tracker to its best ability, but I don't know how to implement it and really make it as successful as a Facebook group.
Yeah, I
get it.
I'm kind of want to transition to the tracker just because I think it reminds them every day, like they can get notifications.
Yeah, that's one of the good things about it.
Heidi just said, we actually have a lot of success in the tracker. Tell us more, Heidi.
I've had a couple challengers come back and be like, okay, this is the thing that's working for me. Put me in all your groups that are in the tracker app. But then I feel like there's more people that are just being lazy. I don't know if there's just not enough people in it or what.
Well, there's. I feel like there's always going to be people like that, right? You know?
Yeah.
Tell us your experience.
I've never had a challenge group where I didn't have at least one person that was like that.
Yeah. What? Do you feel like you're having better success in the tracker app, Charlie and Heidi?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, sorry. Go.
Oh, you, whatever. I feel like I am having way more success in the tracker than I did in Facebook groups. I think it has a lot to do with like the way we set it up and the way we kind of have like a point system, and part of their daily check-in in order to get some of the points is to like cheer on some of the other challengers. And so they kind of are creating their own relationships in there as well. And then, I don't know. We've had a lot of success just because we tell them to always turn on the reminders, which is really helpful for a lot of people. They can contact us right through the app, even if we're not their direct coach. So if they can't get a hold of like one of my coaches who's still learning, they can get a hold of me or whoever is posting. So that's always helpful because then I can direct them to who they are missing. I don't know. We've just had a lot of success with it. We've had them. I would show you our group if I could, but our phones always don't work so well. But they're like posting motivational quotes in there to each other. I think it has to do with our point system. It really does. Because it runs exactly like a Facebook group. I think the biggest struggle between the Facebook group and the tracker is that they post individually instead of all posting in that one spot where you see everyone's on that one check-in post. Instead, they have to individually post. And you definitely have to encourage them post to the group, because that was a struggle for us at the beginning. But because some people, for some reason, are a little bit shy, but just making sure that they know that, like, make sure your post to the group thing is on. And we always encourage them to post pictures. It's worked really well for us.
Yeah, I want to know more about your point system, but I agree with Jody how I found during the health bet people would like not even pay attention to my coach posts, or I mean, maybe they probably read them, they just probably don't comment on them. But
yeah, I'm having the same thing where like people, they don't really comment on my posts as much, but my challenge is just saying that they love that it's like Facebook, but it's not Facebook, because they hated having to check into Facebook every day because then they got distracted and were constantly on Facebook and then forgot to check in. And so they like that and they love that it's tracking everything for them and they love the reminders, but I am finding that I'm not getting as much attention on my posts. But for the most part, my challengers love it.
Do you guys, I don't know what you guys post, so maybe that issue, because that is part of our point system, is for them to check in depending on what we're talking about per group. Like this group, we're focusing on some personal development stuff. And so we got them, when they signed up, we each sent them a book. And so like we check in and it's like, if you want your bonus point for today, tell us your takeaways from the book or whatever today, or just do something little, where when they check in, they basically have to comment on our posts. And if we're not hearing from them, I mean, I love that you can go in and see like, well, they at least checked in today, because you can see how many workouts they've done. And then you can just be like, what is working for you and what isn't working for you? Because you have that whole back office where you can see exactly how many workouts they've logged and everything. So that is really beneficial, at least in my opinion.
I think a simple video tutorial just like explaining, because like a lot of my challengers, they were seeing my posts, but they weren't seeing other people's group posts. Oh, that's cute. anyway, they weren't seeing other people's group posts. And so I think just a simple video tutorial just explaining how to set everything up, because I think that was the only hang up, is that my challengers were like, okay, wait, how do I set this up? Like, how do I turn on my push notifications? Because no one was getting notifications for other people's posts, but they were getting them for mine. And so no one was like interacting with each other. And I was like, we should be friends here. Like, why are you not helping each other? And so I think that's a simple tutorial, or just like writing it out, like the different things, and encouraging them to play around with it during prep week or something.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Someone told me you can reuse the posts, like if you have like scheduled posts that you do, you know, like tips,
it's
or whatever.
The best.
You can just literally like reuse them, which I haven't played, but that sounds amazing.
Yeah, there's a post library basically, and if you posted anything in another group, like basically all you would have to do is post your prep week post once, and then you just hit the post library and it just says copy and post, and you just pick the date and the time and post.
I think the part that you would like about that, Kelli, is that if you're doing that, you're using the same picture, so you can't have different graphics for every single group.
Yeah, I would.
So they'd stay the same like you wanted.
You could actually, you can post, copy and post it, and then you just go into your, guys, this is like my best friend, obviously, if you haven't noticed, I'm into this thing. Anyways, you can go in there, and you can just see your, whatever, your scheduled posts, and just hit edit and you can just swap out the picture.
Oh. I didn't know that part.
So
I'm actually going to start my, I'm going to make my Forever Fitness group be in the tracker app. I'm going to post about it in my Forever Fitness group. I want to put them in the tracker app and then do, I might even do my own little mini health bet for my past clients. Like, not a health bet, but like if you do 3 workouts and 5 Shakeologies, because then I'll be encouraging them to drink Shakeology still, then you can, and you'll earn, you know, if you do that for a whole month, then you'll earn this prize. That's something I'm thinking about for my Forever Fitness group, because I don't want people to just fade away after the first month. So I want to like put them in a themed group, and then after that first month, then put them over to like my Forever group and have people still in there. So that's something I'm thinking about. Actually, I'm definitely doing it. That's something I'm doing starting November. Heidi, we might need you. Heidi and Carly, maybe you guys will give us a team meeting next week on the tracker app. I want to know your point system.
Okay. Well, and if you're saying like that your coaches aren't seeing your posts, you can pin your posts to the top in the tracker app too, just like on Facebook.
Okay. Yeah, that's what I do. We have been doing a point system. My husband keeps track of points for me, and then I just like do little leaderboards and kind of like with the successful leaderboards. My husband does leaderboards, and he gives them to me and I post them. To kind of show them where they're standing for the prize and stuff. And we're doing more of a drawing, like for every 3 workouts they do, they get an entry. For every 3 Shakeologies they drink, they get an entry, so they can get like 4 points a week. Because they can get 2 for workouts, 2 for Shakeology and stuff like that. And then they get put in a drawing so that way if someone's put into the game a couple weeks after someone else, they still have a chance to win something, but not as great of a chance because they haven't been in as long. But then it's an ever going, like an ongoing fitness group, and I just switch up the prize every month. And it's, I mean, we're still kind of playing around with it, but it's helpful. I like it.
I like also the tracker app how at the home, there's like all those different views, right? From home, it shows the most recent coach posts always. Mm-hmm. And then if you go to the symbol with like the people, that's like the group feed, and it'll show you like everyone who's posted in the group, and you can have a pinned post at the top of that. Like that. Sorry, I'm echoing. I don't know what happened, but I just think there's lots of really good things. There's files you can upload. There, like, and one thing I've been doing is I do like a weekly giveaway, and so there's like a challenge every week. Like, go post on 3 other people's posts and show them support, and then come back here and post when you're done. And I get a lot of really positive feedback about these challenges. Like, oh my gosh, this is so great! Like, I need to do this more often. But when they have an incentive, then they do it. You know, and so then they're talking with each other, they're getting to know each other, and then after, I always do that the first week, and after that, they like are constantly commenting on each other's stuff just because they really liked doing that challenge the first week. And then the second week, I usually do like post your favorite motivation or your favorite quote, I don't know, your favorite meme, and they'll post it in the thread or they'll post it in the group feed. So I just think that that's kind of a thing, is to do little weekly challenges. And I send them like stuff I just have from.
See, I love that. Would you mind, like, because I'm in your fall fitness group, so that I.
It's frozen.
Like a file where it kind of tells you, like a guideline for yourself, like it tells you what you're going to do each week and each day. Like, could you send that to me, or if you have one?
I should, but I don't. I just wing
okay.
it.
Okay. Okay. Cool. Every
time. Like, I normally do a challenge every week, and I didn't last week. I don't even remember why. So I just changed. I just did it this week instead, even though it's week 3. So.
Yeah. Okay. Well, good to know. Well, I'm just going to like stalk your group and like. Stuff. Take some stuff.
Honestly, we have really good interaction and it's fun, and I think it's been good.
That's awesome.
Yeah, I want to like take all these ideas and systemize them.
I know. I'm like the same way, like, thinking of systems so that I'm not stressed and my brain's going nuts right now. Like, I want to do all the things all right now.
Yeah. Well, okay. 15, we're a little bit over our time. Do we want to continue? I do want to hear more about your point. I think this could be a whole nother call. Do we want to just continue talking
next week again?
Okay. Because I think it'd be cool to hear lots of people's like point systems and challenges and what works. Because I know, you know, Stephanie does, I've got some coaches that do total, you know, that do a variety of things. It'd be cool to hear everyone's like different systems and hear what's working. And then we can like take little nuggets and make our own.
Yep.
Because then we'll be ready. If we do this next Tuesday, then we'll be ready for our group that starts on the 7th. We'll have a game plan. We can get them in the tracker app and do some cool point systems and weekly challenges. And, you know, I think it'll be awesome.
Woo!
Yeah. Holla. Okay. Another combined meeting Tuesday at 7. Does that work? Does this same time, same place work for your team, Melissa?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, cool. I'm excited. I'm gonna be annoyed that I have to wait a whole week to hear all these. but yeah, this has been a great talk. We could go on and on, I'm sure. But yeah, it was a great, you know, really, that was the whole thing, was just to help our clients get better results. And I think that it'll have a ripple effect into, you know, sometimes we get so caught up in recruiting and we're like, oh, I just suck as a coach, so I'm not recruiting. And it's like, if you're helping people get results, then you're doing awesome as a coach. And eventually those people are going to want to become coaches and join in on the fun. And if you're having fun, then you're doing it right. So that was kind of the main thing, was to get back to helping your clients.
Well, and I think that if you're teaching your coaches to just focus on that too, then your business is going to get better, like income wise. And then if they teach their coaches to do it, then it's helping, like by doing that and duplicating that, you are helping with the recruiting side and with the business side.
Totally. Totally. So thanks you guys for joining us. Any last thoughts for Melissa?
No, that was great. Thanks.
All right.
For hosting.
Yeah, it's fun to chat with you. And come November 1st, Team She's gonna bring it.
Nuh-uh, Team Petrup.
Whoop, whoop. All right, you guys have a good night. We'll see ya. Okay. Bye.
Yeah.